Edwards. I'm the team leader here at KW Success, and I'm super excited today to have JC Christensen with me. JC is one of our newer recruits to the office, and JC and I have been friends for a long time.
Seems like forever.
I met JC years ago when we were doing a deal together, and one of the things that I probably said to you at the time is like, one day we're going to be in business together, because we thought very similarly. I loved the way JC was so passionate about how he worked with his clients. I knew that he was just all about a win-win, and just the attitude that you had was very similar to what Keller Williams' kind of motto and vision value statement was. So
I remember you telling me that.
I did tell you that. So tell me a little bit, what initially drew you to KW?
With the changing market, I wanted something that was different, fresh, a different culture, and I'd worked with, I think, three different Keller Williams agents in the last several months and had great experiences with them, and they were all positive and really had a driving personality, and I appreciated that, and so I talked to you a little bit more about it, and then I just felt like there was a lot of positivity, a lot of drive, and I'm kind of a statistics person, so I noticed that Keller Williams had a lot of listings.
Yeah.
More so than my previous company. So I thought, I want to be where the listings are, and I bring a lot of buyers, so I thought more listings, help my buyers, and I do a fair amount of listings myself, and so I thought that would be a great opportunity to at least talk to you, so I did.
Yeah. And we talked several times over
a long
period of time, but also for many years we just were friends, and there was a lot of times where, this is what I love about JC, I would call you, like, you and I had a transaction together that was a VA buyer. Yeah. You had a VA buyer. Yeah. I had the listing, and because of our transaction that time, there was times I would call you and go, hey, I'm having this issue, what would you do?
Right.
Because you and I thought so similarly along, we just do whatever it takes to take care of our clients and make sure it's a win for everybody. So I loved that about you too. Tell me, what do you want to accomplish this year?
This year, I was just really focusing on getting my name out a little more. I wanted to meet some different people in the industry. Mm-hmm. I came from a company that was very well known and highly regarded, and I saw that same aspect with Keller Williams. So I thought the next best step is Keller Williams, especially in this area, in Ogden area, Weber County, Davis County, even up into Box Elder, and now we have an office in Cache Valley where I work. So
yeah,
I just wanted to get to know more of the agents, more of the industry, and then I know Russi is involved in the NWAOR and a lot of other things in the real estate industry, and I wanted to get a little bit more involved and active in that area.
Gotcha.
So that was pretty much it.
So getting more listings and then getting just more involved in the community as a whole.
Right.
Are kind of some of your goals for this year. Okay. Tell me, what would you describe to someone who's not familiar? And I know you're newer to Keller Williams, but I think you've gotten a good taste of the culture and the environment here. How would you describe our environment to someone that wasn't familiar with it? Kind of the culture of KW.
I would say, well, I noticed that, again, there's a very positive attitude. And as far as the market goes, I appreciate in the training and the meetings that we have that everybody's honest. This is the way it is. No, there's no skirting around the truth. And one of my mentors previously always said there's power in telling the truth.
100%.
And it's not always, yes, it's important for us to tell the truth to our clients and other people that we deal with, but also to ourselves. And we need to be honest about what's going on, maybe it's the difficulties, how we're approaching it, how we're going to improvise or strategize our business. And so, yeah, I saw the potential there. So that really impressed me. And now that I've been here, yes, I've been involved in the 80s telethon at the NWAOR. And then we did Red Day, which was, I found out what Red Day was. And
how did
I
you like Red Day?
Red Day was
from an outsider.
Yeah, that was
like brand new.
You know,
KW.
At first I thought, oh, I'm going to go to this person's house and paint and do yard work. Two of my most favorite things in the world. That's my one. Anyway, once I got there, I was excited to be there, and it was and realized that many hands make little work. So it's like we were able to accomplish quite a bit in a short amount of time. So that was, it was a good feeling, good camaraderie. During times that might be a little more difficult when you're giving of yourself, definitely gives you a great feeling and great karma or great power.
Yeah. One of the things I love about Red Day too, and I just kind of kept thinking about this after the day, because that day was, it was hard physical work, and just thinking of the impact it was going to make in just this family's life, but then thinking of Keller Williams globally and the impact that was made on that day of all of our offices. Like, just what was happening in Utah was huge. Right. And then to think of that spanning across the globe was amazing for me. So I always love, like, I think your first Red Day is something kind of fun and special that you'll always remember.
That's true. And that's a great point to think that that was just here.
Yeah.
And the impact that it made on the family. And the family was there helping with all the agents. And that, you know, we were just all having a good time, rubbing shoulders, talking about life. Didn't need to be about business. And it was just great to get together and get that done for that family. It was awesome.
Yeah. I love that you mentioned integrity too earlier, because that's actually one of the core values of KW. And again, that was one of the things that drew me to Keller Williams. That and the win-win or no deal. And that was like, when we worked together, there was some hurdles that we had to jump over, but we both were all about a win for both of our clients. Neither one of us were, only one of us was going to win in that situation. It was a win-win or we weren't going to make it happen. So I appreciate that about you. That's one of the things that why I wanted to be in business so bad with you that I wouldn't give up.
Well, I'm glad you didn't give up.
So I want to do just like some rapid fire, get to know JC. Is
all
that
right,
okay?
Sure, go ahead, rapid.
Favorite candy?
Oh, those chewy Mentos, the mint ones that you add to Coca-Cola and they explode.
Those are good.
I did that experiment with my son.
You did? My son's dying to do it.
He's like, can Riker come to your house and do it? Dad, can I use Mentos and Coke and do this experiment? I said, wait till I get home. He's 7 years old, so.
That's hilarious. What's your favorite thing about real estate?
I think just being able to take challenges, and whether it's and helping somebody find a home or sell their home or move from one to another and not be homeless.
Yeah.
When people are nervous or have fear, even other agents feel that anxiety, and I felt that in the beginning as well, but I'm very positive, and I knew that I could be successful. And so once I was successful, I thought, I want to share this. And so, you know, that's really what I love is the accomplishment. Yes, I've received awards and trophies and have spoken to groups. And that's all wonderful. And getting paid, you actually get paid for doing this. So I've been paid extremely well for the last 6 years. And I just, but that's just not what it's all about. It's really making a difference and in my clients' lives, in other agents' lives, within the industry. Those things are what's going to be remembered.
I seriously love this about you, because you don't just talk the talk, you walk the walk. Like, even a short time into our office, I came to you like you'd been here maybe a month, and I'm all, JC, I need you to be a team captain of our listing contest.
Right.
But I knew that you would make people feel comfortable being part of your team. And I watch you with even some of the newer agents and some of the agents that aren't new. Like, this is a challenging market that everybody's questioning what they're doing. And I love that, like, again, you don't just talk the talk, you walk the walk. And I know that you have that openness, and you're always willing to help. And I love that about you.
Oh, I appreciate that.
What's your favorite book or podcast?
I like Joe Rogan podcasts. So, other than that, I've been reading Ninja Selling.
That's a good one. Great book.
Lately, and so I don't really have necessarily a favorite book. Yeah. I like to dabble in a little bit of everything, but I like that podcast. But I also like to watch other podcasts of other real estate agents. Sometimes they'll do a podcast and post it on YouTube. So Ricky Carruth, he's on the East Coast. I'll watch what he's doing as far as real estate. His market's totally different. The way he approaches it's totally different.
Yeah.
He's interviewed some agents here in Utah and they all have different ideas, and I liked it because he goes, yeah, that works for you. I'm not saying to do what I do, but
yeah,
you know, what you do works, what I do works, what Rusty does works, what people on my team, for the listing competition, they're all different, and there's so many things that you can, different ways to make this business work for you.
Yeah, for sure. What's your favorite drink?
Diet Coke. I should be drinking more water.
Who's somebody that you look up to or a mentor of yours that's made an impact in your life?
Probably it seems like there's I have family members that I've looked up to, whether it's my mom. In the industry, I was at Coldwell Banker. There was a few leaders there that have moved on to other companies that I really liked. There was a Journey to Mastery training there, and that was by Doug Yeaman. He's the one that says power comes from telling the truth. So I really like Doug Yeaman and his information that he shared was, so those... Those people.
Love it.
And maybe you.
I had to pay him to say that.
Just no, she didn't.
What is your favorite thing to do when you're not selling real estate?
I like anything outdoors. But I mean, I'll do something as simple as a drive. You know, my teenager's not going to be into that. Just taking a drive through country or seeing some place that we haven't been.
Yeah.
And but that's something I like. But other than, I do like outdoor sports, fishing, hunting, hiking, camping, ATVs. We have kayaks, paddle boards, water sports like that. Something that we've gotten into. And so pretty much anything outdoors and traveling.
Yeah. Well, you live in the perfect state for
that. Yeah. It's a pretty great state.
Okay, last but not least, and this is probably the most important question. Who's your favorite team leader?
You.
I'm your only team leader, so
Rusty,
that's the right
Edwards.
Answer. Okay, well, thanks, JC. I appreciate you just sharing a little bit of
your
KWY. We're so glad to have you as part of the KW family. It's been a long time coming. And honestly, it puts a smile on my face every day when I see you walk in the door because you're just such a happy, positive person and I love it.
Well, I appreciate it. I appreciate you.
Okay.
Thanks so much.
Thanks.